Hi guys, thank you for watching us. Today we will show you how to make a peach mango cobbler. Peaches are so good and I love mangoes. So the cobbler that I make with these two fruits, peach and mangoes, oh, they're so good. This is probably the easiest cobbler you will make. If you haven't made cobbler before, you will find out that it's really, really easy to do. So let's start with the ingredients. One cup of peaches, peeled and sliced. Half a cup of mangoes, peeled and cut. If you like more fruits, you can actually add more fruits to it. Okay, half a cup of sugar, and 1/2 teaspoon of salt, 1/2 cup of all-purpose flour, and 1/2 cup of instant oats. I just adding the oats just so it will thicken up a little bit better. It will come out with a good consistency. 1/2 cup of butter that's melted. 1 1/4 cup of just regular milk. 3/4 cup of brown sugar. 1 tablespoon of baking powder. Remember, it's not baking soda, it's the baking powder that you have to use. Okay, 1 tablespoon. And to taste, or just 1/4 teaspoon of cinnamon, just to make it tasteful. So this is what you have to do. Take a saucepan and then you add the peaches to it. There we go. And add the mangoes. And this the half cup of sugar to it. And 1/2 of this salt, just to taste a little. So now we have all these together in the saucepan. Add just a little bit of water, maybe 1 to 2 tablespoons of water, just so it doesn't get in the bottom, okay? So now we have to take this and boil it. We have these ingredients together in the saucepan. So let's take it to the stove and turn it medium to high heat. And we have to boil it for about 6 to 8 minutes. Once it's boiled, you can let it cool. So here we have our boiled fruits that's in the syrup. It's looking really good. And it's been sitting here for a little bit to cool. So now we can keep it aside. What we have to do for the mix is take a bowl, and we have all the dry ingredients. We have this all-purpose flour. Add that to the mix. We have our oats, the salt, baking powder, brown sugar. Let's mix them all a little bit. Now that all the dry ingredients are together, mixed together, we're going to add our milk to it. And mix all of this together. You can see the consistency. It's a little liquidy, but not too runny. But if it's thicker, then you can actually add a little bit more milk. But this looks about right. Only because we are adding that oats, if you want to make sure it's not too thick. So here we go, we have this. So now all we have to do is we add the butter to the pan, kind of swirl it a little bit so it gets to all around the pan. And now we just simply dump it, dump the mix that we made with the flour and the oats. So put it all together. Now we add the fruit mix to it, just like that. You don't have to mix it, okay? Just dump it all together like that, and then you add a little bit of the cinnamon, ground cinnamon, just to flavor it better. So I just put a little bit. That's about it. And now it's ready to go. You just have to have the oven on for 375 for 45 minutes. Put this in there and wait for 45 minutes. Here is our freshly baked peach mango cobbler. It just came out of the oven. It's the smell of the mango and the peach, it's so good. So let's see, it's nice looking and brownish and it looks just perfect. So let's take a little slice, a little bit of it and try. You can kind of mash it if you like it. You can kind of mash it and take a little piece. It doesn't have to be perfectly, okay? So the fruit will mix in with the flour part. So let's take a little bit. While it's cooling a little bit, I just want to tell you, while you are making the fruits, you know, cooking the fruits, if the water is not there much enough, and if it's starting to burn, make sure, don't let it burn. Add a little bit more water if you need it. A lot of the times the fruit, since it has a lot of fruit and water in it, it will kind of seep out as it cooks. So just make sure you don't, you know, let that happen. Don't let that burn. So let's try this, and don't forget to like, share and subscribe so we can add more videos to our list and you can watch, enjoy and make these things at home. Let's try. Nice and crispy on the top, really nice moist fruits in the inside. It's very delicious. It's probably the easiest cobbler you'll ever make. So don't forget to make it at home, share with your family and get lots of compliments. Okay, thank you so much for watching. Till next time.